We read in Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 16. What does it say? Can you read Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 16? He often will withdraw. The word used is withdraw. We get busy with very many activities. Here is the secret. Here is the key given to all of us. Very many times, as many times as possible. In some Bible it is written, as many times, in this very many times, he withdraw himself and alone with the Father. If you have to be nourished, you have to constantly eat food for your body. You have to nourish your body in the same way. If your life has to be nourished, you need to nourish with His presence. Yes. As many times as possible, He withdrew to be in touch with His root, to empower His root, to nourish His roots, to strengthen His roots, that He can be able to face the heat, the sun, the rain, the storm, the earthquake, whatever may be happens outside. So He has to withdraw Himself. If I don't eat, my body becomes weak. I can't even stand. The same way, my life cannot stand without God. So we need to withdraw. This is the secret word used, withdraw. Jesus withdraw with his, from his activities, and he was with the Father. If we don't withdraw from our activities, Satan will take us to the activities which will make us zero. If you don't walk in plus, the next is walk in minus. That's what we read in mathematics. If you don't walk towards plus, automatically you walk in minus. The more you walk in minus, the hard it is to return back. Because walking in plus, walking with the presence of God, is like climbing on the mountain. Once you are in the mountain, it is easy to come down. But without walking with God, is moving towards the valley. Once you have fallen in the valley, it is very hard to, you need some trees to climb. You do not know what kind of things are there. It will be slippery. So once you move into the valley, it is hard to get up. It is in the valley, the drained up water, the smell in the mountain water will not stand. In the valley it will stand. Poison will remain in the valley. Poisonous snakes live in the valley. So, valley is very, very dangerous. So, if we don't withdraw ourselves, that's why we read in the book of Matthew, chapter 14, verse 23, it is written, they were in the lonely place, and then he did a great miracle of, with the 5 loaves, he gave food for 5,000 people. And then they wanted to make him the king. What did Jesus do? Read the word. And having sent the people away, he went up on the mountain. See the, what the Bible says. He went up on the mountain and he prayed there the whole night. He went up, withdraw, going up on the mountain. These are the keys God gives to us. He withdrew. You need to invest time. Without invested time, nothing grows. And we have to invest time. as much as I try to develop my talents, I need to be in touch with the one who gives me the talents. It is not sufficient, because without him, the one who gave me the talents, I cannot proceed much with my talents, with my abilities, with my riches, with my beauty, with my education, with my social status. I can't do nothing. So as much as I have this, I need him. So withdrawing, first term. The second term is, we find in Jesus, climbing up alone with the Father. Because on the mountain, people don't go. People don't move. The animals, they remain in plain. Few animals, except like a tiger, they climb up to a level like trees. But to climb on the mountain, only like deer and few animals climb, because they are safe there. They come down for water and many other things. That is the way God has made. That's why David could say, like the deer longs for you, Lord, I long for you. Withdrawing, longing for God, and climbing on the mountain. Jesus spent the whole night in prayer. That's what we read in Matthew 26, where we read Jesus spent the whole night in the Garden of Gethsemane before he offered himself on the cross. To face life, you need to strengthen your root. To face your difficulties, you need to strengthen your roots. To face the world with all its temptation, you need to withdraw from the world, and you have to climb up and strengthen your roots. Very, very important. That's what in Joppa Peter learned to do. We read in the first sentence, the news came to the apostles and the brothers and sisters in Judea that even foreigners had received the word of God. So they should be happy. They should rejoice that even those who do not know Jesus Christ have come to believe in the word of God. But what happened? When Peter went up to Jerusalem, these Jewish believers began to argue with him. Without withdrawing, without climbing on the mountain, you will not know God. You will only argue. You will only fight with. They are apostles, yes. They are the brothers of the Lord, yes. They were with Jesus, yes. They are meant to go all over the world to preach the word of God, yes. But what are they doing? They are arguing. They are fighting with. Why argument in the chosen group? Why there is fighting? They are saying, they are blaming. So when they said, you went to the house of uncircumcised people and ate with them, blaming, abusing Peter, that you are done blunder. Where there is no prayer, where there is no withdrawal, where the group is not strengthening the root, there will be only arguments, there will be only fightings, there will be only blaming each other. These are very, very common. When God's children come together, the enemy comes to destroy the servants of God with these three important tools he has got: arguing, fighting, blaming each other. Arguing, fighting and blaming each other. These are the three important tools Satan brings into the lives of the apostles and God's servants whenever they gather. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.